Ladies and gentlemen, for the year 2000, youth women 14 to 15, slopestyle national champions right here. Don't let the coach do it, you can do it.
As I was ski racing, like from 5 years old on, I had a couple guy friends that were snowboarding after the ski races, and I thought that it was the coolest thing ever. And so my mom, when I was 9 years old, it was Christmas of 1993, she surprised me with a snowboard. She got me a couple lessons because she didn't want to teach me, because obviously she didn't know how. And from the first day I took my first lesson, I was hooked. And I just found like such a different kind of relationship with snowboarding than I did with skiing. I put all of my focus on snowboarding. And I started competing with USASA, and I sent out a sponsor me video to about 8 sponsors, like Shannon, Dunn, and all of these people at different companies, like Burton. And my sponsor me video, heaven forbid if it ever made it in this, is like horrendous. So I just had it converted. It's horrible.
I'm Kimmy Fasani and I'm from Truckee, California.
One of my sponsors was Velvet Eyewear. And when I was in their office down in Southern California, they handed me a VHS tape and said, hey, this girl sent in a sponsor me video. You want to check it out? And I was like, yeah, sure. And I popped it in, and this girl goes off this huge jump. And does a backflip.
Come on, Kimmy, stomp it. Woo! Yeah, Kimmy! Yeah.
Woo! When I found out her age, and right now I can't remember, but she was really young. I wanna say like 13, 14, something like that. I was like, that's amazing. This girl's totally going for it at 13, 14, whatever her age was. Kimmy Fasani, I'm gonna give this girl a call.
I ended up getting a call back from Shannon Dunn. I don't even know what I did in that moment. I was so shocked that this woman and pro rider that I had looked up to for so long was now calling me directly.
I don't really remember that conversation so well, but I do remember having a conversation with Burton and saying, you should check this girl out.
She got me on the rep level at Burton, and that really helped escalate my passion for snowboarding, because I realized that maybe there was a future in it for me, and I just became even more enthusiastic about who other pros were, because Shannon was so nice to me and really kind of took me under her wing. So I joined the Burton family when I was 15 years old on the rep level, and then that kind of escalated into me competing for a few more years, winning nationals 3 years in a row, and at that point I moved to Mammoth, and Mammoth became this kind of breeding ground of professional snowboarders, and my mind was just totally blown away when I moved to Mammoth in 2002, just after graduating high school, and I would see Tara Takedas and Kevin Jones and the whole Grenade crew. It was this very surreal feeling that I had kind of found my way into this sport that I had a deep connection to.
Awesome, Kimberly!
Dialy, baby.
When I worked for the company Velvet Goggles and Version and Recon with all those guys, it was on my K2. Actually, was my first TM job, marketing job, whatever, and I dealt with all the girls too. And Kimmy was just one of the groms on the team. And I think the first time I met her, we were doing a shoot, and she was this little kid sitting on a bench. And her legs, and she was probably with Jamie Ashton, her legs literally did not touch the ground. They were little kids. So that was my first interaction deal with Kimmy. Like I said, full grom, local Tahoe girl, on flow for this women's goggle brand. And like I said, so small and so little that they were sitting there waiting for me, helmets on, you know, they looked like, you know, like little kids look, like big helmets, big goggles, everything looks big on them. And sitting on a bench waiting, like, hi, I'm Kimmy. Just this cute little girl that has turned into probably one of the leaders of women's snowboarding, I'd say.
Hey, for real, quiet on the set. Sorry. Let's see. Kimmy first came onto my radar probably right around 2004, 2005. I mean, it was just in that the heat of the Mammoth expansion. Grenade had was blowing up continually. Everybody needed to be in Mammoth, and then here was this ripping snowboarder from Tahoe. I remember asking Colin Langwell, I was like, who is that? She just seems to be chucking meat every day. She was just hungry. You could tell that she was super hungry and getting after it in Main Park. When at that time, you know, there was such a small clique of women that were getting after it. You know, you had your Tara Takedas, Hana Beaman, and Kimmy was kind of next up on like the Mammoth scene. You know, from the early 2000s, I mean, even till today, riding in Mammoth, you know, it's basically like a football player being able to walk on the field for a Patriots game or something, and then you're just part of it. When you have pros like Danny Cass and Kyle Clancy and Eddie Wall, and then, you know, a couple years before that, you had Kevin Jones and Tara Takedas just lapping the park, and you can hop on a chairlift next to them, you can wrap out, and you can just follow them through the park and watch how they ride. How do they view the terrain? What tricks do they come up with? And that's exactly what Kimmy did. Sponge, just absorbed everything and was all in on how am I gonna get better? I'm gonna ride as much as I can because that's what they're doing. And I'm gonna start trying these really hard tricks.
I mean, Kimmy is also just a light, a bright light. I think this industry is definitely better off for having her. You know, I know she's faced a lot of life challenges. It's funny, you know, when you first meet her, you think, oh, this bubbly, wonderful, blonde athlete. And then you realize she's had to face and overcome a lot of life's challenges, but she's never lost that positive outlook and that positive attitude. And so for me, it's been, you know, she's inspired me, especially over the last couple years, to stay positive.
She was riding for Burton, and she would just be at the events, and she just had so much heart and just gave it her all, and you could just tell how dedicated she was to snowboarding. Just seeing her doing, you know, the first double backflip that she did, I was just like, whoa, okay, like Kimmy is ready. Like she is getting it. Like her hunger, she is motivated. And that was really cool. That is the time frame of where she almost kind of like harnessed her power and like what she had to offer. And I think it gave her a little more self-confidence to like go after it and like go after what she really wanted and not be ashamed to ask for it and to kind of demand it in a way.